Hello everyone, welcome to or welcome back to my channel. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Lena and I make college and book related content here on YouTube, and today I will be sharing with you all my February wrap up. As many of you probably know, February is Black History Month, so this month I made the effort to make sure all of the books I was reading were written by Black authors and contained Black stories. I also tried to read more nonfiction than I usually do, which is basically reading nonfiction because I don't really read that much to begin with, as part of Black History Month is obviously Black history, and I wanted to read some nonfiction to continue to educate and re-educate myself. So without further ado, let's get into the video. I read 7 books in the month of February, and the first one I read was The Color Purple by Alice Walker. This book follows the story of Celie, who is a young Black woman living in the South in the early 20th century. This book covers a huge span of time, and it is told through a series of letters that Celie writes at first to God, but eventually she begins writing to her sister. I mentioned this book in my Black History Month book tag, which if you haven't seen that already, you should definitely check that out. And this is my favorite Black classic. I read it as my first book in the month, and it was a great way to start off the month. I gave this book 5 out of 5 stars. Celie's inner resilience and strength is something so beautiful and so powerful to behold. The relationships that Celie forms with the woman around her, whether they're friendships or romantic entanglements, are just so wonderful to read about as well. There's so much power, and this book really explores what it means to be a Black woman. I also found the scope of this novel to be very fascinating. It talks obviously a lot about Celie's life in the small town in the South, but it also goes into the bigger world and looks at some missionary work on the African continent and how that plays into different issues back in the United States as well as abroad. And I just found this book wonderful to read, incredibly powerful, and just so, so good. And I highly recommend this read. The next book I read in the month of February was The New Jim Crow, Mass Incarceration, The Age of Colorblindness by Michelle Alexander. This is my first nonfiction read of the month, and I really enjoyed this book as well. It basically covers exactly what the title says. So look it up if you need a more specific synopsis than that, but I give this book 5 out of 5 stars. This is such an important and essential read. It's been on my TBR for a long time, and I'm glad that I finally got around to it. Something specific that I really enjoyed about it were all the laws and landmark cases and policies that have been put into place. I think so often Brown versus Board of Education gets thrown around and we just act like that solved the problem and then it was the end of that, and like racial discrimination like doesn't exist anymore, obviously because we're in the age of colorblindness. I just found so many of those cases and explorations of that to be fascinating. Michelle Alexander did an excellent job writing this book. She was very straightforward and upfront about what she was trying to say. She organized this book really, really well, and it was a pretty quick read in the scheme of nonfiction for me. There are also many things that I didn't know or hadn't thought about that she brought up, things about like affirmative action and maybe the issues with that, as well as other issues. I highly recommend this book if you haven't read it already. It's been out for 10 years and it is just as important and timely. The third book I read in the month of February was Full Disclosure by Cameron Garrett. This follows the story of a high schooler named Simone who is starting over at new school. She is the student director of the school's musical. She has a new love interest, and she's really just trying to start over and have a new chance at life. She's also HIV positive, which is something that she does not share with people around her because at her last school it ended horrifically. As she starts to become closer and closer to Miles, the guy she has a crush on, she obviously knows that she needs to share this information, but she starts receiving threatening notes in her locker, threatening her and telling her that she needs to stay away from Miles or they will reveal to the entire school that she is HIV positive. I gave this book 3 out of 5 stars. I really enjoyed many aspects of it, first and foremost being the sex positivity that was present in this book. This book, it's just an excellent read. Honestly, like maybe read this for health class or something. I just think it had a great exploration, and it destigmatized so many things, not only being HIV positive, but what it means to be bisexual or part of the LGBTQ plus community. I just found that to be really wonderful. And so many times, it's not even that people are saying like practice abstinence, even if they've moved beyond it. This book just was so open and upfront about everything, and I really, really enjoyed that. I also learned more about what it means to be HIV positive. This is a narrative that I haven't read a lot about or am very familiar with, and I found that to be a very compelling story as well. Simone was a really likable character. Miles, I just loved him so much. He was so sweet and so great. I really liked Simone's dads and the relationships that they had. That was just really sweet to read as well. The reason why I didn't give it 4 or even 5 stars is for two reasons. The first being, I was not a fan of the writing style at times. I was confused as to what age the characters were, because even though it told me how old they were, they did not read that way. They sometimes read like 12 or 13 year olds. And then I just didn't always like the writing style. Sometimes I felt like I was being pushed out of the book and not really engaged with it. And then my biggest issue, which this is like more of a me thing, was one of Simone's greatest character traits was that she was very into theater, specifically musical theater. There were so many references and so much about that, and I am just here to say that it was wrong. As someone who, I'm not like 100% into theater, but I know quite a bit about it. I was in theater for many, many years, and I know a lot about it because my sisters are very into it as well. I'm here to say that Hugh Jackman is not a good Jean Valjean, no matter what this book says. I'm also here to say that like Hamilton is not the one-stop shop. Maybe that's just me, but like if you're truly into musical theater, Hamilton really isn't the first one that comes to mind. That being said, I still enjoyed this book, and I think it had great themes and great messages to offer. And also, Cameron Garrett and I were born in the same year, so like hats off to her for being such a great writer. The next book I read in the month of February was Memorial by Brian Washington. This was my book of the month for the month of November, I believe, and I finally got around to reading it. This book follows the story of Mike and Benson. Benson is a Black daycare teacher, and Mike is a Japanese chef at a Mexican restaurant. Mike gets the news that his father is really ill and is actually dying back in Japan, so he flies back to Japan to be with his father. At the same time, his mother shows up and has to live with Benson because she has nowhere else to live, and it just follows the story of Mike and Benson and their relationship, and like, are they really meant to be together, as well as family and the messiness and the love that comes with it. I gave this book 4 out of 5 stars. I adore this writing style. I know it's not for everyone. I saw a lot of people complaining about it. I just love this writing style so much. I love the jumping around, the short little moments. I just find it so refreshing and so engaging. And it was also just incredibly raw and incredibly human. It talked about what it means to be gay, what it means to be Black, what it means to be Asian, what it means to be HIV positive, what it means to maybe be poor growing up or live in unhealthy family dynamics. It just covered so many things, and I found it so, so beautiful to read. It also talked about death and the beauty and the pain that comes out of death. Talked about the messiness of love, the messiness of family, and how it is necessary in life. I found many of the characters to be so fun to read about, and I really liked the shift in perspective because it starts from Benson's perspective, and then it goes to Mike, and then it goes back to Benson. The reason why I'm not giving it 5 out of 5 stars is because there were parts of Mike and Benson's relationship that I was a little uncomfortable with, and I don't know if that's just because I'm so young and so inexperienced. And I also was confused by the ending. So if anyone understands the ending, feel free to leave it down in the comments below, because I was not quite sure what the meaning of it was. But overall, I really enjoyed this book, and I'm glad I read it. The fifth book I read in the month of February was The Prophets by Robert Jones Jr. This was my book of the month for the month of January. I wasn't supposed to get book of the month for January, but I could not stop myself, and I got it anyway. This follows a story of two enslaved men on a plantation in the South during the antebellum era. Isaiah and Samuel are two enslaved men that work in the barn, and they are also in love with each other. One of the other enslaved individuals is trying to say that their relationship is wrong and that people should turn against them, and people are starting to turn against them. And then there are also many other issues going on, because obviously this is slavery. And this book, I gave 5 out of 5 stars. It is a beautiful book. My synopsis did not do it justice. It's so well written. It's beautiful to read. It's also incredibly hard to read, and as a result, very, very hard for me to review. I read this book in 2 days, and the first night that I had been reading this book, I had to stop reading because I felt so sick to my stomach, and I recognized the privilege of me being able to say things like that and sit here and review this book. And by the time I finished this book, I was deeply, deeply disturbed, and I can't quite place a finger on what it was. I didn't really review this book well in my video, but I just wanted to give a quick list to further explain why I gave this book 5 out of 5 stars. I don't know that I can recommend this book because I had such a strong reaction to it, and I think I maybe should not have read it, but I do know that I want to come back and read it because it was so amazing, and I don't want to knock this book at all. I just don't think I was in the right headspace for this, but it is a beautifully written book. After I finished that book, I really needed a light read. I needed to de-stress and decompress, and so I read His Only Wife by Peace Adzo Midi. This follows the story of Afi, who is a young woman living in Ghana. She is put into an arranged marriage with Eli, who is with another woman that the family does not like, with the hopes that if he marries her, then he will leave that other woman behind. Afi also has dreams of becoming a fashion designer, and so she goes to fashion school when she moves to Accra, which is where she's supposed to live with her future husband. But things are not as they should be, and Afi has to come to terms with what she should be doing for herself instead of other people. I gave this book 3 out of 5 stars. It was a fun read, and it actually surprised me by having some deeper themes. It gave a great taste into Ghanaian culture. I found that so fascinating and so rich and well done. I also really liked Afi as a main character. She was likable, she was funny, she was so real and human. I will say, I was unsure why exactly she felt the way she did about Eli. Without giving any spoilers, I didn't get it. Maybe that's just me. I just didn't really understand why she felt that way and why she continued to feel that way throughout the entire book. I will say, though, this was a really fun read. This is another book where I didn't understand the ending, but I really enjoyed this book, and I'm glad I read it because I got a great taste of Ghanaian culture, and Afi was a wonderful character to read from. And the last book I read in the month of February was Ordinary Hazards, a memoir by Nikki Grimes. This is clearly a memoir of her life. It basically starts from when she was around the age of 6 till her late teens, and it is written in verse with some prose interspersed throughout. I gave this book 3 out of 5 stars. This book has really, really, really high reviews on Goodreads, and I just did not feel the same way that many people felt about this book. It was a very, very interesting story and an important story. I always believe that people should have the freedom and the ability to share their life story because everyone does have something to offer, and Nikki Grimes had so many wonderful things to discuss and share and explore. I was just not a fan of the writing style. To me, when you write in verse versus prose in novels, there's a point to it. There's a point that helps with the execution or the delivery of the novel and or the memoir, and that just was not the case for me. I didn't really enjoy the poetry at all. That being said, there were some notebook entries from her notebooks that she kept when she was young, and I found those to be really, really fascinating and a great window into who she was as a person. I will say, what I walked away from this book with is Nikki Grimes really shows the importance of representation. She is able to see the author James Baldwin and see a Black writer just like herself. Her father brings her to movies, to art shows, to operas, to concerts, where she is constantly surrounded by Black culture and Black creatives, and that is just so, so important. She really emphasizes that importance and how it really shaped who she was and who she became. And I just think that for people who doubt what it means to have someone that looks like you in a position that you want or would really love to have, this book just shows the importance of that, and I really enjoyed that aspect. I just don't think the writing and the style and I clicked as well as we probably could have. So those are the 7 books I read in the month of February, and I am currently reading Caste, The Origins of Her Discontents by Isabel Wilkerson. I feel like me and everyone's mother, brother, everyone is reading this book right now. I am currently on page 100. I just started part 3, The 8 Pillars of Caste. So I'm probably just like getting into the thick of things by now. What I can say about this book is giving a much broader picture of history. A lot of the books I've been reading are more contemporary. I think that Isabel Wilkerson has some great points to make. I will say I'm not a fan of all the random metaphors that are interspersed throughout. I just kind of feel like I'm wandering in this book right now, and I want this book to just take a direction and stick with it. That being said, Isabel Wilkerson has brought up some great points, some wonderful things to think about, also just some horrible things to think about that make me uncomfortable, but that's good. I should be uncomfortable because, as she says so many times throughout this book, is we just can't ignore our history and we can't act like the 20th century was ages ago because it wasn't. So I think that this is a really great read, and I'm hoping just to continue to finish this book up in the month of March, hopefully, and I will let you know my full review then. So that's it for my February wrap-up. If you have any questions or book recommendations, feel free to leave them down in the comments below. If you have any thoughts about the books that I read this month, please share them with me. I would love to hear what you think. If you haven't already, give this video a like and subscribe, and I will see you all next week. Month of as